water or signs of water or where water would like to be in the landscape is everywhere you turn here. The tracks don't run in straight lines, they wind through these wetlands and floodplains and over these little sandy outcrops, and away you go again into more sort of places that water is really important, and all the animals and plants have adapted to you know, wait for that water to come. It's very smart country. This place knows how to take advantage of that bit of moisture that it gets every now and then, and it never knows when it's going to get that next drink. Beautiful yapunya trees, coolibar trees, the lignum, fresh green growth on it.
Naree's about 145 kilometres northwest of Bourke, about 14,500 hectares, and adjoins Yantabulla Station, which we also manage. That's another 16,500 hectares. This country's beautiful and amazing in any state, I think. It's a harsh looking landscape, but the longer you spend here, the more you see that all these little things are going on that you're not aware of, and then you get a rain event or a flood event, and then all this stuff just springs to life depending on when that flood event is.
Yantabulla Swamp is a big, beautiful wetland of national significance for a few reasons. One is because of the way the flooding and drying cycle happens. It's unregulated, it's natural, it's that pulse, and then the drying, the boom and the bust, if you will, sort of, that happens at Yantabulla Swamp, which is really, really, really important for waterbirds. That there's a study years ago where 70,000 waterbirds were recorded on Yantabulla Swamp, which is one of the highest numbers of birds recorded in a wetland system. And it's also that water and the connection to culture and, you know, Aboriginal life. And every time you get out of the car at a clay pan or in a floodplain, you see evidence of budgety life. So it's that mix of water, it's biodiversity, and it's culture. It's really powerful here. They're putting out a network of motion sensor cameras, and what they're going to do is give us a really good sense of the activity of some of those threats to the values of the property, like feral pigs.
The pigs will root around in the mud and just create a bog hole where there was a pristine gilgai or you know, a water hole or whatever. The goats will just eat anything and everything in their path. Yeah, we need to keep pressure on those feral populations to give our natives a chance to get a foothold and to survive at the numbers that they're supposed to survive at.
We're in it for the long haul. We want to work with the traditional owners to look after this country, and if we can alleviate some of the threats in this landscape, then we're doing a small part and a big job.